سورة الانشقاق في الشابتر نمبر 84 وستيل giving the interpretation of جزء عامة لص جزء من الهولي القرآن and this سورة مكي شابتر 25 verses and most of these chapters which is the جزء عامة or the chapter number 30 they are short surahs. Let's talk very fast about the merits of the chapter. What is the message? On doomsday, heaven will split and the earth will sunder out. The righteous will be happy on that day and they will receive their record with their right hand. In this life, people are tired to receive their livelihood. In the hereafter, everyone will be accountable on what he used to do. The denial of the disbelievers to the Quran will be punished for doing so. Anyone denying the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will receive news of the punishment of the hellfire. Let's go after the merits of the chapter. Let's go to the verses inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said from ayat verses from 1 to 5, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إذا السماء انشقت وأذنت لربها وحقت وإذا الأرض مدت وألقت ما فيها وتخلت وأذنت لربها وحقت. See the meaning of this ayat. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us some signs of the day of judgment. What gonna happen during that day? Said when the heaven is split asunder and has responded, وأذنت لربها وحقت, and has responded to the command of its Lord and was firmly obligated to do so. And he said, وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ, and when the earth is extended and flattened out. وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا وَتَخَلَّتْ, which is those who are in the graves. وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا وَتَخَلَّتْ, and has cast out what is within it, the dead people, and becomes empty. وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ, and has responded to the command of its Lord and was firmly obligated to do so. يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَى رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. Allah, if we have this verse, only this verse from the Holy Quran, it's enough. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you in this ayah number 6 in Surah Al-Inshiqaq about your final destination. Where are you going? فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. He said, O man, O insan, indeed, you are striving in this life and doing good and bad deeds. Then you will return to your Lord for being justly judged for all of your deeds. Since you come to this life, you are giving your back to this dunya and you're turning your face to Allah. Every day, this makes you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَى رَبِّكَ كَادِحٌ, مفعول مطلق in Arabic. يعني you're going to Allah strongly, very strong in a strong way. كَادِحٌ كَادِحًا, مفعول مطلق. إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه. You are going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have a title here, the reward of the people of the right, those who are going to receive their record with the right hand. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهله مسرور. I'm asking Allah to make all of us, Ya Rabb, from amongst them. Then whoever will be giving his record in his right hand, he is surely will be reckoned easily, inshallah, and will return to his family in paradise rejoicing. What's your family? The family, your family, the new family, they are waiting for you there. Yes, the hur'een and mashallah. And also your family in dunya, if they will be with you in Jannah, inshallah. Yeah. And also the destiny of the people of the left, those who are going to receive their record and their book of a'mal, deeds, with their left hand. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. You're going to explain that now. فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورَ عَيَّةٍ تَحَرِّمْ حَشْحَرُدْ عَلِيهِ وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا. وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ يَحُورَ. بَلَى إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى seeing those who are going to receive the record from their back, the back of their back, these people, they will be in hellfire. And Allah is telling you, I'm not zalim. Why they going to go to hellfire? And they said in the ayah. Let's see the meaning here. But he who is giving his record behind his back. Sometimes in the Quran he said with his left hand, and this ayah said for behind his back. Why? What is the difference? Of course, in the day of judgment, when that person will receive his record with full of shame, a lot of bad deeds, he's going to receive it with his left hand like that. And he's going to look at it. There is no hasana. All shame. What are you going to do? You're going to be shy. And you're going to hide it behind his back. This is exactly the meaning. Because most of the ayat Allah said, you're going to receive with his left hand. But this ayah said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. He's going to receive his book from his back. How? This is explanation. This is what the scholar said. He's going to receive it first with his left hand. Look, no hasana, all shame. If he's going to be ashamed in front of everybody, he's going to hide it. But the one who's going to receive his book with his right hand, Surah Al-Haqq explained it. He's going to jump. He said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُهَا أَوْمُ قُرَأُوا كِتَابِيَ إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَ فهو في عيشة راضية في جنة عالية قطوفها دانية إلى آخر الآيات. But Allah is telling you the condition of that man. He's jumping. He's so happy. Look at me, guys. I'm not ashamed. I'm happy. I'm very proud of my good deeds. This is exactly what the Quran said. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, soon will he cry out of his destruction in hell, and he will suffer and will be burning in blazing hell. Was not he so arrogantly happy among his family? This is the reason now why he's going to go to hell. In the earthly life, indeed he must have thought that he would not have to return to Allah and would not be judged for his deeds. He never expected that day. He denied. He was thinking he's going to be dust and dirt. That's it, in the grave like what some people think. But yes, Allah said, indeed, his Lord was ever watchful over him, all seeing of his actions since the day of his creation. Allah said, no, inna rabbahu kana bihi basira. Akhir ayat, last ayat here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty swears by the coming of the day of resurrection. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ means أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ وَاللَّيْلِ وَمَا وَسَقِ وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا اتَّسَقِ لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ لَا يَسْجُدُونَ للسجدة هنا بل الذين كفروا يكذبون والله أعلم بما يوعون فبشرهم بعذاب أليم إلا الذين أمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم أجر غير ممنون. This is the finish or the end of the surah. The meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear. Nobody asked Allah to swear. Who believe you, Rabb? Who, like the Bedouin man. When Allah said, رزقكم في السماء وما توعدون فورب السماء والأرض إنه الحق. Allah said, your livelihood, your risk in the مقادير الرزق in the سماء. Allah said, وإن من شيء عندنا خزائنه وما ننزله له بقدر معلوم. مقادير الرزق في السماء بس الرزق في الأرض. When that ayah being recited to the Bedouin man, he never went to any school. Just by nature, by fitra, he, subhanallah, he understood Arabic language. Allah said, رزقكم في السماء وما توعدون. Your risk in the hand of Allah. في السماء مقادير الرزق. فورب السماء والأرض. Allah swore by the Lord of the heaven and the earth. And the Bedouin man, he said, Ya Rabb, we believe you. Why you swear? Subhanallah. Who made Allah angry to let him swear that our risk in the السماء. Subhanallah. We have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he swore by Shafaq. Allah Almighty swears by the two light redness of the sunset. Shafaq, that comes after between Maghrib and Isha, immediately after Maghrib. That's where Rasulullah said, Salat al-Isha, when the Shafaq, the redness of the, and after sunset of the sky disappear, the Isha, this is Isha time. That's why Maghrib is very, the time of Maghrib is very short. يعني you have to pray Maghrib immediately after the Azan. Don't delay it, because if the Shafaq disappears, the redness of the sky after sunset means that Maghrib gone. Don't worry about this time here. Maghrib's gone, خلاص, that's it. Maghrib غريب. Don't delay the Maghrib. And by the night, when it covers every creatures and animal. And by the moon, when it is full. والقمر إذا اتسق لتركبن. Look at this ayah. لتركبن طبقا عن طبق. This is your destiny. This is your life. Verse number 19. I love this ayah. I always talk about it. لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ. We are traveling to Allah. And they said before, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَادِحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. See, two ayat talking about the same meaning. We are going to Allah. Wallahi. Look what Allah said. That you, human, shall pass from one stage to another. Starting from his conception in the womb of the mother to his life on earth that ends by death. This is tabaqan an tabaq, from stage to another stage, from stage to another stage. Since he was in the womb of your mother, you go to alaqa, mudgha, kada, idham, lahma, and then you come to this life, and then you live happy, sad, rich, ghani, whatever. كل يوم هو في شأني. Too many things happening to you, ups and downs in this dunya. Then you're gonna die. Then you're gonna be in the grave. Then the grave jannah or fire, and you're gonna be on the day of resurrection. طبقا from a stage to another stage. See what going to Allah. Subhanallah. Look what Allah is saying us here. Yes, and they said then to his resurrection and finally to his judgment. Indeed, swearing by any but Allah is an act of disbelief. And Allah said, after all these clear signs, why they do not believe? فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. And when the Quran is recited to them, why they do not prostrate and do not submit to Allah? لَا يَسْجُدُونَ. This is one of the 15 sajda in the whole Quran. Indeed, the nature of the disbeliever is the denial and belying the truth. And when it comes clear to them, and Allah has the full knowledge of what they conceal in their chests and hide within themselves. So announce to them, now Ya Rasulullah, huh? Deliver the message. Announce to them, Prophet Muhammad, the tidings of a painful punishment. فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ. When Allah said bushra, tidings means something good. When Allah said عذاب, punishment, and he used that word, bashirhum, just to put them down. Like, subhanAllah, if somebody make you sad or make you mad, and smile to him and tell him, tomorrow you will see, inshallah. Give him a smile. This is a smile from Allah to them. Saying, give them tidings. With what? Painful punishment. Yes, because these people, they were stubborn. They deny the Quran. They deny Rasul. They deny Islam. They deny Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And they insisted themselves to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal and to make haram. فَسُبْحَانَ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا إِسْتِثْنَاءَ هِنَا بَأَهُوَتْ. Allah يَسْتَثْنِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ from all of this punishment. الحمد لله يا رب we are مؤمنين. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. It's not enough to say I'm a mu'min. You have to follow your iman with righteous good deeds. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. Your reward will never be cut off. Like Surah Al-Teen. والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين أمنوا وعملوا الصالحات the same فلهم أجر غير إيه ممنون يعني إيه your reward will not be cut off means all of your life ما شاء الله you're trying to do best and you're doing your salah somehow somebody gets sick now he cannot move from his chair now he's in death but he lives some time. Do you know, even if he's not praying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will run his salah as if he's praying. Yeah, the reward will be continuous. Why? Because all of his life is to do the same action. For your reward will never be cut off. If you die and you leave behind your bag sadaqa jariya or anything good, like a credit for you, thus your ajr will be continuous until the day of judgment. Huh? And you know, there are too many ahadith, not have time to talk about it now, except from those who... though being punished, Allah said, istithna, except for those who believe in Allah and His messengers and do righteous deeds, for them there will be a reward in paradise that will never come to an end. I'm asking Allah, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to make all of us amongst those who are making righteous good deeds and believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. آمين يا رب العالمين اللهم ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا وحقق إيماننا وارفع درجتنا نسألك العلى من الجنة نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك نسألك يا رب السلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار يا أرحم الراحمين عافنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وأبداننا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا برحمتك يا رب العالمين
اللهم يا ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا يا ارحم الراحمين، واسترنا فوق الارض وتحت الارض ويوم العرض عليك يا رب العالمين. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذريتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. ربنا اتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامه انك لا تخلف الميعاد. ربنا ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا يا رب العالمين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد اذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمه انك انت الوهاب. ربنا انك جامع الناس اليوم لا ريب فيه، ان الله لا يخلف الميعاد. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.